just a brief history of the building. And then if anybody has any questions, you're welcome to stay after and ask me or Norbert Brown, the guy standing on the little tall ladder taking pictures behind me there. the Pantheon, they started the Pantheon in 1919. It was by far the biggest theater in Vincennes. But Vincennes, back then, you guys, people didn't have a lot of radios or televisions or the internet or cell phones. And so people went out and went to theaters a lot more back then. And so at one time, over the years, Vincennes had 20 or 30 different theaters. Norb has told me he's found 34 different theaters that Vincennes had. At the time the Pantheon was going, you had the New Moon in the Fort Sackville, you had the Strand, the Rialto, the Alice Theater down on 2nd Street. And so going to the theater, like I said, you didn't sit at home, and you came to the theater. That's why a lot of people are always amazed how big the Pantheon is. The Pantheon was built of 1,200 people. They had 550 seats downstairs and 650 seats upstairs. It took them a couple years to build. One of the questions we get a lot too is what they did here. What I mean by that is they did a little bit of everything here. They had live shows. As you see, we got a pretty good sized stage here. They did live shows from Broadway, New York, which seems odd to us today that they would come to a small town like Vincennes. But the Broadway shows, a lot of them travel by train. And as you know, Vincennes has a lot of trains that run through it. And so they would do a show maybe in Cincinnati, get on the train, stop here, and then keep going to St. Louis, or vice versa. We also had other big name, we also had other big name entertainers like Duke Ellington and John Philip Sousa and Count Basie and other big orchestras of the time would come and play. They also brought, they also brought like world-class entertainment, like opera singers and violinists here. They had famous violinists from Russia would come here and perform. And they also did movies. I had to wake him up from a nap to come here, so not real friendly. They also showed movies here. Now, there's a projection booth in the back, and so they showed all the big movies of the day, Gone with the Wind and Casablanca. At the beginning, they showed silent movies. When you guys came in, it's hard to see from here, but on each side of the stage, there's some lattice work. And that lattice work, behind the lattice work, were pipes for the pipe organ. At the time it was built, we had Indiana's largest, probably most expensive pipe organ. And unfortunately, they took it out when the talkies came along. They didn't need the pipe organ anymore. But we have a group who we think is going to donate us a pipe organ once we get open. And we can show silent movies once in a while again. But like I said, they did do movies, live shows, and they also did plays, Broadway plays. They did one called Rain here, where they actually hooked up a whole system and it rained on stage. And they had a drain where the water would drain off. They had small circuses here. There's been bears and camels. And Roy Rogers came here with his horse. And other famous performers came here with animals and everything. So there's just been all kinds of things on stage. Down below where you're sitting, there's actually a basement underneath all of this. And there's 11 dressing rooms for the performers to change clothes. Again, some of the Broadway shows had big casts and crews, so you needed a lot of dressing rooms for them to change in. Above your head is the Fly Gallery. Fly Gallery held 52 curtains and backdrops. And you think, why in the world do they need so many? Well, if there's 52, you have a real fancy front curtain, and also the movie screen would raise up and down. But they had all kinds of other curtains and backdrops. For instance, they did Ben-Hur here, the play Ben-Hur, and other, like they did Robin Hood here. And so you're gonna need backdrops to show where you're at, like in a castle or in the forest of Robin Hood's forest. And so they had all these backdrops they could drop back here and kind of do for the plays. And they had 15 miles of rope to run all those curtains and backdrops. And they had flymen who would stand up there and control all the curtains and backdrops. I'm sure I'm missing a lot, but we'll get on with the wedding. So, like I said, if you guys have any questions, one real thing, the theater was open until 1961. closed in 61. It's going to sound crazy, but they took all the seats out and they filled where an orb and then were standing to fill the orchestra pit with sand and concrete and leveled it out to the street. They also put a fake suspended ceiling through the entire building and they rented it out to Sears. It was a Sears, then it was a bunch of other just different rentals over the years. And we formed a nonprofit in 2006. And purchased the building, and our goal is to turn it back into a theater. We're going to have live shows here. We can have live shows here. We can also show movies again here, and then we can have big bands come and play on stage. So, like I said, I'll get it shut up and let the ceremony begin. If anybody has any questions, just stick around and ask me or Norm.